Hi everyone. Now we'll move to the part 10 of this chapter 4. The problem number 11 from the exercise 4C. Here in the given equation is x square minus root 2 plus 1 within bracket x plus root 2 equals 0. Now what we have to do? We have to just multiply this term which is in bracket by this x. Now in the next step we have x square minus this plus minus is minus root 2 multiply x is root 2x and minus with plus is minus 1 multiply x is x plus root 2 equals 0. Now what here in the next step what we'll do, we'll take the LCM of the first and second term and similarly for the third and the fourth term. Here between the first and second term, what is the common factor here? Here you have x square and here you have root 2x. That means x is the common term between these two. Therefore, take x as a common term. Then x multiply how much to get x square? X multiply x is x square. Then minus x multiply how much to get root 2x? X multiply root 2, you get root 2x. Okay, that means after taking x as common, you have x minus root 2. And then here you have minus sign. And between the third and fourth, the third term is x, fourth term is root 2. Here neither x nor root 2 is common term, therefore we'll take 1 as the common for both these two. Now when you take 1, this minus with plus, minus with minus, you have to multiply. This minus with minus is plus. This mean this 1 multiply how much to get x? 1 multiply x is x. Then this minus with plus again minus 1 multiply how much to get root 2? 1 multiply root 2 is root 2. Then x minus 2 here this term which is in bracket they are the same. That mean your calculation is correct. And next step you'll take x minus 1 and then x minus 2 you'll take only once. X minus root 2 within bracket equal to 0. Now if x minus 1 x minus 2 is 0, that means either of this 1 should be 0, then x minus 1 is 0 or x minus root 2 is 0. And taking it to the right side, x equal 1 or x equal root 2. Okay, now with the next one, x minus 1 by 2 whole thing square is equal 4. This is the given equation. Now what we'll do here, this if you do the expansion, you can do the expansion also here, a minus b whole thing square, but that will be little lengthy process for doing that. Therefore instead of doing that, what we'll do, we'll multiply by the power of half to both sides, the left and the right. Now here if you multiply x minus half holding square multiply the power of half, this 2 and 2 get cancelled. That means you will get x minus 1 by 2 to power 1. That means it's x minus 1 by 2 itself. And then 4, when you multiply the power, 4 power is 1 and you multiply with power of half, that means you'll get 1 by 2. And 4 power half, what does this mean? 4 power 1 and in the order of the root is 2. That means it's square root of 4. Square root of 4. Now what is square root 4? Square root 4 is 2, isn't it? Therefore x minus 1 by 2 is equal plus minus 2. Once we take the square root, there should be two sign, one is plus, the other will be minus. Okay, now here you take this half to the right side, will x equal plus minus 2 and this minus half take right side will be plus half. X will be, once you take with 2 or with plus 1, take with the order would take with minus. This means 2 plus 1 by 2 and minus 2 plus 1 by 2. Now here, the next step, what we'll do, we'll take the LCM of 1 and 2 is 2. 2 divided by 1 is 2. 1 is in denominator. And 2 multiply 2 is 4. Here, 2 divide 2 is 1. 1 multiply 1 is 1. Same thing on the, here also. You take the LCM of 1 and 2. LCM is 2. 2 divide 1 is 2. 2, 2, 4. And then here, you'll get 1. Now, the next step, 4 plus 1 is how much? 5 by 2. And minus 4 plus 1 plus minus minus. Minus 4 plus 1. Which is greater? You have to subtract them. 4 minus 1 is 3. Which is greater? Plus or minus sign? It is minus sign. Therefore, minus 3 by 2. Okay? This is the solution for the given equation. The next, we have number 13. The number 13 is 3x squared minus 14x minus 5 is 0. Okay, this is the given equation. Now what we'll do, look for the coefficient of x squared and the constant term. What is coefficient of x squared? It is 3, constant is 5. Now 3 multiply 5 is 15. Now find out the factor of 15. 3, 5 is 15, 5 is 5, 1 is 5. Now, out of this factor of 15, 3, 5, and 1, you group them in such a way that if you add or subtract, you will get 14. Now, if you group them 3 and 5, 3 and 5 is 15 with 1. Now, 15 minus 1 is how much? Is 14. That's why instead of 14, you will write 15 minus 1. Okay? Now, in this next step, we have 3x squared minus, instead of 14, we are writing 15 minus 1, x minus 5 is 0. Then the next, we have 3x squared. This minus with plus is minus. 15 multiply x is 15x. Again, minus with this minus is plus. 1 multiply x is x. And then minus 5 equals 0. Now, same thing here. The first and second term you have to take common. Which is common? X definitely is common because here is x, here also is x. Between the number 3 1s are 3, 3 5s are 15. Therefore, 3 is the common term here. Now, you 3x, if you take common 3x, 3x multiply how much is 3x squared? 3x multiply x. That means you will get x here within bracket. Then minus 3 multiply how much to get 15? 3 multiply 5. X we have already taken common, therefore no need to write x. 3x multiply 5, you get 15x. And then the next, between third and fourth, between these two there is no common term, therefore keep 1. And here plus plus is plus. 1 multiply x is x, and plus with minus is minus. 1 multiply how much to get 5? 1 multiply 5. That means you get x minus 5, x minus 5, the same thing. Therefore, we'll write 3x and with this plus 1, and then x minus 5, we'll write only 1, and that equal to 0. And same thing here, if these two is 0, this means one of them should be 0, either 3x plus 1 is 0 or x minus 5 is 0, would give us 3x equal minus 1, x equal 5, or x equal minus 1 by 3 and x equal 5. Okay, it's clear. Now we move to the next number, on number 14. Number 14 is, the given equation is x squared minus x minus a plus, and within bracket a plus 1 equal 0. Now, procedure for doing this also is the same. The coefficient of x squared is 1. Now, 1 multiply a, within bracket, a plus 1 is the same thing, a plus 1. Now, to get here, the coefficient of middle term is 1. Then to get 1 here, we'll use with this, we'll group them a and a plus 1 so that the sum or After subtracting, you will get 1. How you group them? You keep a plus 1 and the order is a. If a plus 1 minus a, what you will get? This a and this a get cancelled because 1 plus 1 minus, you will get 1. That means instead of this x middle term, you will write with a plus 1 minus a. Okay, next step is x squared minus, in bracket we have a plus 1 minus a, would actually give us how much? Would give us 1. And then this bracket, close in bracket, then x minus this term is the same. The next step, we have to multiply this x to the term within bracket. Minus with plus here is minus. A plus 1 multiply x is a plus 1x. Then minus with this minus, it is plus. See, this minus, you have to multiply with this minus, it is plus. Then a multiply x is ax. We are removing this bigger bracket. And then here, the last is the same, minus a plus 1 equal 0. Now we have the fourth term here, first and second. Between first and second, which is common, is x is common. Therefore, you'll take x as common term within bracket, bigger bracket. X multiply x is x squared. Therefore, we have x here minus. Then x you have taken common, you have only a plus 1 in within bracket. Then close bigger bracket plus. Now between these two, third and fourth, which is common? A. X is not common term because here in the fourth term x is not there, therefore only a is common. A multiply how much you get ax? A multiply x, and this plus with that minus, plus minus is minus. And once you have taken a within bracket, we have only a plus 1, close bracket, and that close bigger bracket equal 0. Now here look, this term which is under this bigger bracket, x minus a plus 1, x minus a plus 1 is the same thing, you'll take only once. You'll have x plus a, then x minus a plus 1 with smaller bracket close by bigger bracket equal 0. Okay, now removing this bigger bracket, you have x plus a, then x, this minus with plus is minus, and minus with plus again minus. That means you have x minus a minus 1 equal 0. Then x plus a should be 0, or this thing should be 0. If x plus a 0, taking a right side, it is minus a. And if this thing also is equal to 0, then you take this term to right side, minus will become plus, and minus 1 will become plus 1. Therefore, these are the solution for the given equation. Next, we have number 15. The given equation is 5x plus 1 by x equals 6. Now to simplify this, you just multiply by x throughout the equation. We have 5x multiply x, 5x squared, 1x multiply by x, this means x in numerator and denominator, they will get cancelled, you have only 1s. On the right side, 6 multiply x, you get 6x. You bring this 6x to the left, you have 5x squared minus 6x plus 1 equals 0. And this you will do the same, in the same way as we have done earlier. You try to complete this by yourself, and again you continue to do as homework on the number 16 as well. Okay, you try to, because if I do all the solution here, you have nothing to do by yourself. Therefore, I keep this one for you to practice and complete this as your homework. Okay, for the time being, I'll stop it here and we'll continue it again on the next part, which is on part 11. Okay.